There are three P's. Three P's that you should take into account when you choose, when you select the wine. First P is, can you guess?
Price.
Price, of course. This is the most determining factor when you in selecting a wine. In my case, I thought wine is very expensive beverage, so that is only for the rich who can afford it. But nowadays, there are lots of great wine which is available for a cheaper price, around $15. So when you think of selecting a wine, you should first consider price. And as I heard from my friend, there in the US, there is a wine which is very cheap. So it has, and so it has a nickname, $2 wine. It costs under $2, so it has a nickname, $2 wine. I don't know the specific name of the wine, but there is. So you can find it and try it. And it is very popular because it's cheap, and with that lower price, we can enjoy wine.
So. They sell it here or just in France?
In the US.
Oh, in the US, okay.
But I couldn't find it in Canada.
Okay.
And next to P,
price.
When you select a wine, you should take into account your
preference.
Preference.
You should, by tasting many kinds of wine, you should know your preference. What kind of wine, what flavor of wine do I like? Sweet, dry, and so you should know your preference. And third P is?
Give me a clue.
When do you drink wine?
Party.
Party. So in the party, with wine, what do you eat?
Pork.
Pork.
Food. So you should take into account of the pair. So you should consider the match.
How to match?
Which? What kind of food will you prepare for your party or dinner? So actually, different wine match different food, different kind of food. So for white wine, white wine goes well with fish or lighter flavored food, like snack or cheese, cake, something like that. And for red wine,
meat.
It complements well with meat or more healthier food, like meat, steak. So these three P's should be considered when you select the wine. How to store wine. Actually, I have an experience. My friend gave me a wine, expensive wine, but I didn't know how to store it properly. So I just keep it, stand it this night. So after a few months later, I tried to open it, but I failed to open it because the cork dried, so I couldn't open it, so I couldn't drink it. So you should know how to store wine properly. First, keep it cool. The optimal wine storage is right around 55 Fahrenheit degree. It means 23 centigrade degree. Excessive heat or excessive high temperature will havoc on a bottle of wine. It is not good for wine, the quality of wine. So keep it cool, and also consistent temperature, the same temperature, keep the same temperature is very important, because the fluctuation, the dramatic fluctuation, temperature fluctuation, it will be harmful to the quality of the wine. And also humidity is important. Like I said, the higher humidity level help the wine keep the cork moisturized.
So moisturized.
Moisturized. So
moist. Just moist.
So it will help keep it from allowing oxygen in. Oxygen is not good for the wine, the quality of wine. So the proper humidity level is 65% to 75%. And the second, keep it dark. Keep
dark.
It dark. Exposure to
sunshine?
Excessive and direct light will affect the flavor of wine. So keep it dark. And lastly, keep it sideways.
Sideways?
It means store a wine on its side. On its side.
Not standing upright. Tilted.
Tilted. Oh.
So you will keep the cork, cork moisturized. So keep the cork in consistent contact with the wine. So this will keep the cork from shrinking and also allowing oxygen in. So if the oxygen comes into contact with the wine, the result will not be good. That means the wine can be oxidated. So that means the flavor, the scent, the aromas will be spoiled. So do you remember three ways to store it? First?
Price.
Keep it
cool.
Humid,
dark,
and
sideways.
And finally, the reason why I chose wine as my topic is wine is good for our health. So lastly, I will tell you the benefits. Drinking wine. So drinking wine in moderate amount, not much. Moderate amount of wine may offer some heart healthy benefits. It is good for our health.
Heart health.
So it will boost good cholesterol, and it will help prevent bad cholesterol, cholesterol's forming. So that process will be helpful to our heart health. So to get those good profits of wine. You should try to enjoy moderate amount of wine every day. If you don't like drinking wine or drinking alcoholic beverage, try to drink grape juice. It might also be helpful.
Okay.
Grape juice.
Thank you for listening.